You're listening to Average Joe Sports Talk Podcast with your boy E.
Now that everybody has gotten paid, Baker Mayfield got $32 million, $29.1 million signing bonus. This is a four-year contract, by the way. Sam Darnold got $30.5 million, $20 million signing bonuses. Rosen got $17 million, $11 million signing bonuses. That's guaranteed money, 21.9, 20, and 11. It's time to either put up or shut up. We've heard about the hype, we've heard about the controversies, and we've heard about which quarterback is better, who's ready, and so forth. Let's get on it. Let's talk about it. Let's see which rookie QB is going to have the highest impact, the most impact in the first year. I want to go ahead and start with Sam Darnold. This is what I think about Sam Darnold. Out of all three, Sam Darnold has the highest ceiling than any of the other QBs. Yes, he still needs more time to develop. He's more raw than Josh Rosen. Definitely, you know, may not have the same mechanics as Baker Mayfield, but he is the most physically and athletic ready for this NFL. Definitely needs more time to develop, no doubt about it. Has to work on his mechanics in order to become NFL ready. To me, he has the highest ceiling, the most potential to operate. The Jets definitely found their franchise QB for many years to come. Now you got AJ McCarron, wily vet, who is gonna definitely take him probably under his wing because he's a pro's pro. And the Jets are doing the right thing to build a team around this kid. You know, they're enforcing their offensive line. They got good wide young receivers working on their running game. So they're going to put the pieces together around Sam Darnold. He's going to be definitely the franchise quarterback. Depending on the Jets' record, because I think the Jets overdid themselves last year. Definitely outplayed their expectations. That's why they wanted to trade so low in order to, you know, get Darnold. But I think depending on the record, if AJ McCarron is playing well and the Jets are like 11-5, I don't think Sam Darnold sees the field this year. But if the Jets are like mid-500 and it all depends on AJ's play, then we might see Darnold. I don't think he's ready. I think he needs a year behind a good quarterback like AJ McCarron to learn from. You know, he still has a lot of things to do. He's definitely physically and athletic gifted. This guy makes plays like out of pure intuition. He has that intuition, though. He has that gut feeling, but he's not ready yet. Now let's talk about our boy, Baker Mayfield. Well, my thoughts, should have never been drafted number one. Definitely too small to play quarterback in the NFL. Not a fan of the 5'10s and the 5'11s. Yes, exceptions to the game. Drew Brees, Russell Wilson. But Mayfield is no Russell Wilson. I see more of a Johnny Manziel. Yes, he's been getting praised a lot by Hugh Jackson. Great interview with Colin Cowherd. Colin brought the heat to him. And you know what? I saw maturity there, which that's the biggest knock on him. He came back out strong. He came back strong at Colin with some great answers. But I still see a little bit of Manziel. You know, his history with running away from the cops drunk, you know, it's always going to be there because it's that new age that stuff never leaves you. He's very confident and cocky, no doubt about it. And he has a chip on his shoulder to prove critics wrong. He wants to prove people like me wrong. He wants to prove people like Colin Cowherd wrong. And that's what I think it's giving him a small chance to succeed in this league. Hugh Jackson loves him. Throughout training camp, he's saying this guy can make the right. He's making the right throws. He's out there studying the game book. Him and Tyrod Taylor got this RV that's just for the quarterbacks and is there 24/7. All that good stuff. He's saying all the positive things about him. Tyrod Taylor was named the starting quarterback before even training camp started. So here we are. You gave him all this money, $32 million. You're saying all those positive things about Baker Mayfield. You don't have the confidence yet in him to lead your club. Now, number one pick. Should have never gone number one. He should have been like the actually third quarterback drafted. I think Jared Allen should have been number four in this particular draft. So what's going to happen with Baker Mayfield? This team, if they don't start well, if they're 0-5, Baker Mayfield will be in the lineup. He'll be the starting quarterback because that market would not take it. You're going to put him in to put people in the seats. His playing time, it's going to be based on how bad the Browns are. If they're really, really bad, they stick up the joint. They dumpster fire this baby. He'll be playing. He'll be playing in five games. I don't think that's going to happen. They put some good pieces in the team. They got great running game. They have a lot of these, you know, combination backs. Jarvis Landry is a great pickup. Defense has gotten better. They improved their O-line. Tyrod Taylor is a quarterback that manages the game, does not take risk, and does not turn the ball over. So I think Baker Mayfield may not see the field. Again, too small to play quarterback in the NFL. He's no Russell Wilson. Now, Josh Rosen. Josh, I was shocked Josh fell down to the number 10 pick. I honestly thought Sam Darnold would be the first quarterback chosen in this draft. I always thought Saquon Barkley was going to go number one. And I thought Josh was going to get picked number two quarterback, and then Sam Darnold, and then, you know, make Baker or whatever, or you know, Jared Allen. This kid is out of the three, the one that's NFL ready. He has an NFL arm, NFL mechanics, NFL brains, NFL confidence, which equals to be NFL ready. He's probably going to start more games than any of the other rookies QB. And this is what I'm saying there. You know, you got Sam Bradford, who has been an injury-prone career. By the way, Sam Bradford has earned more than $150 million in his career and has barely played, you know, right place at the right time. But I think Sam Bradford is going to get hurt. This kid's going to come in. That's going to be the only knock. I mean, that's going to be the only thing. The only knock I have on Josh Rosen is his concussion history. I think Josh has too many concussions already this early on in his career, which might make his career not very long if he gets hurt. This is not college. This is not high school, man. When you get hit in the NFL, players are faster. There's a lot more chances of concussion than you did semi-pro. Should have been the number two quarterback pick, or number one, ahead of Allen and Mayfield. The kid has an IQ out of this world, very high IQ, which makes him NFL ready again. Has this goofy look to himself, right? Very little expression, kind of like Eli Manning. He reminds me of Eli Manning. He's a goofy looking dude, which leads me to compare him to Eli. Now, Eli was NFL ready from the day on, since he got drafted. I see the same kind of career path if he doesn't get hurt or have no concussions to do Eli. Don't let the goofy look fool you, fellas. This kid could play. Josh can play. And Eli hasn't had a bad career. Two Super Bowls, not too shabby. You know what? I think Josh can have the same career path and have the same numbers. So here you go, folks. I put Josh number one. I'm putting in Sam Darnold number two here and Baker Mayfield. Baker Mayfield's probably going to get the start earlier, but it all depends on what the team does. Now, let's see who's the real deal. Josh Rosen, Sam Darnold, or Baker Mayfield. It's time to put up or shut up, fellas. And let's get busy. Let the NFL season begin.